Okay, good morning students. In this class I am going to explain the sum of integral angles of a quadrant. So first of all, here you can see what is the sum of interior angles of a quadrant. So we know that the sum of interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. Sum of interior angles of a triangle is 360 degrees. 360 degrees. So prove this one. I want to prove this one. What is that? Sum of interior angles of a triangle is 360 degrees. So first of all, you construct a quadrilateral, whatever it may be. You can call this as ABC. First one. Construct a quadrilateral. Okay, completed. After that, you can join diagonal AC. Second step, join diagonal AC. Now here already we know that, so in a quadrilateral, angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D. What are the angles? First of all, now this angle A can be divided into angle 1 and angle 2. No problem. Here you can also, this is angle 1, this is angle 2, 3, angle 4, and then angle 5, and then angle 6. Already we know very well, the sum of interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. Very good. Third one, third step is sum of interior angles of triangle is equals to 180 degrees. Here you can see from triangle ABC. So now here you can write what are the interior angles of triangle ABC. 3, 4, 5. Angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle 5 is equals to 180 degrees. Angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle 5 is equals to 180 degrees. You can assume this is equation 1. Now one more triangle. From triangle, what is another triangle? ABC. From triangle ABC, what are the interior angles? 1 plus 2 plus 6. Angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 6 is equals to 180 degrees. This is equation. This is equation. Is it clear? Now we need to find the sum of interior angles of these four angles, angle A plus angle B plus angle D. So now we can add 1 plus 2. Plus equation 1 plus 2. What is equation 1? Angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle 5 plus angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 6 is equals to 180 degrees plus 180 degrees. You can add all LHS, both LHS parts and both RHS parts. So that means angle 1, now you can write in a proper order. Angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle 5 plus angle 6 is equals to 180 plus 180, 360 degrees. 180 plus 180 equals to 360 degrees. Now you can write, instead of angle 1, you can write angle 1. Yes. Otherwise, instead of angle 1, you can write angle D plus 2 plus 3, you can write it as angle A. Instead of these two, you can write angle A plus angle 4. Instead of angle 4, you can write angle B plus 5 plus 6, you can write angle C. Angle C is equals to 360 degrees. Now you can write in proper order. Angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D is equals to 360 degrees. Now sum of interior angles of the quadrilateral is how much? 360 degrees. The sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. Is it clear? Yes, very nice. Now I am going to explain What about the exterior angles of a quadrant? Sum of exterior. What is the sum of exterior angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. Now here you can first of all construct a quadrilateral. So this one is A, B, C, D. Here you can observe. So you can take it as interior angles. This is angle 1, this is angle 2, this is angle 3, and this is angle 4. Otherwise, you can write here you can write angle 1. Here you can write exterior angles. So now we are taking exterior angles, angle 1. So this is angle 2, this is angle 3. And this is angle 4. This is angle 4. Now, what are the exterior angles? Exterior angles equals to exterior angles is equals to angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, and angle 4. Angle 1, 2, 3, 4. And then interior angles equals to interior angles is equals to angle A, angle B, angle C, and angle D. Angle A, angle B, angle C, and angle D. Now, comes to this one now. Here you can observe, this is a line segment. So, this is a line segment. So, then, here you can join like this. So, this symbol represents linear pair of angles. Now, here you can write. So, angle A plus angle 1 is equals to 180 degrees. Why? Because linear pair of angles. Linear pair of angles. So, next second one, angle B plus angle 2 is equals to angle B plus angle 2 is equals to 180 degrees. Same reason. Third one, angle C plus angle 3 is equals to 180 degrees. With the same reason. Next, angle B plus angle 4 is equals to 180 degrees with the same thing. You can assume this is equation 1, this is equation 2, this is equation 3, and this is equation. Is it clear? Yes, very good. Here I am going to write, add all those things from 1, 2, 3, and 4, and equation. From 1, 2, 3, 4. So here you can do 1 plus, 2 plus, 3 plus. I'm going to add all those things. Now finally I'm going to write. What is equation 1? Angle A plus angle 1 plus angle B plus angle 2 plus angle C plus angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle B. So here how many 180s are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 is equals to 180 degrees plus 180 degrees plus 180 degrees plus 180 degrees. Is it here? Total 180 degrees. Now you can write it is in a proper. Angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D plus here you can write angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 is equals to 720 degrees. 18472, so that's equals to 720 degrees. Already we know that what is A plus B plus C plus D, these four are the sum of interior angles. Already we implemented in this class only, what is our previous proof? The sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360. So simply here we can substitute that 360 degrees. So 360 plus angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 is equals to 720 degrees. So now finally we can write angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 is equals to 720 minus 360. So therefore finally you are getting angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 is equals to 360 degrees. Now, what is this angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4? These 4 are the exterior angles. Already according to our assumption, what is that 4? Exterior angles. Therefore, the sum of exterior angles of the quadrilateral is exterior angle of the quadrilateral is 360 degrees. Is it clear? Is it clear, man? Yes, very good. Now I'm going to explain one more proof, one more theorem. So find the sum of interior angles of a pentagon. Sum of interior angles of a pentagon. First of all, you construct a pentagon. So you can assume these vertices are A, B, C, D, and then so four sides pentagon. Here you can construct so two diagonals AC and BD. First you construct AC and BD. Here you are marking the angles 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9 angles are. So already we know that. So, I mean, can you able to write this construction? First of all, construct the pentagon. After that, you construct two diagonals AC and AD. Construct two diagonals AC and AD. Now, from the triangle ABC, from triangle ABC, here what is the angle? 1, 4, 5. Angle 1 plus angle 4 plus angle 5 is equals to 180 degrees. Why? Because sum of angle of the sum of interangles of a triangle equals to 180 degrees. Here you can write sum of interior angles of triangle equals to 180 degrees. Similarly, you take from this triangle, from triangle, what is that? ACD, angle 2 plus angle 6 plus angle 7 is equals to 180 degrees. Angle 2 plus angle 6 plus angle 7 equals to 180 degrees. So with the same reason. So one more triangle is there, from triangle AED, from triangle AED, angle 8 plus angle 9 plus angle 3 is equals to 180 degrees. Okay. Now we need to calculate the sum of interior angles of a pentagon. Now here you can add. So this is equation 1, this is equation 2, and this is equation 3. We need to calculate all the sum of the angles. So writing place 1 plus 2 plus 3. 1 plus 2 plus 3. Here you can add all those things now. What is equation 1? Angle 1 plus angle 4 plus angle 5. Plus what is second one? Angle 2 plus angle 6 plus angle 7. And what is third one? Angle 3 plus angle 8 plus angle 9 is equals to 180 degrees plus 180 degrees plus 180 degrees. So finally you can write in a proper order. So here you can write angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle 5 plus angle 6 plus angle 7 plus angle 8 plus angle 9 is equals to 83 54 540 degrees. So here you can see, instead of angle 1 plus 2 plus 3, you can write angle A. For these 3, you can write angle A plus 4, you can write angle B plus 5 and 6, you can write angle C. 7 and 8, you can write angle D. And then last 9, you can write angle E is equals to 540 degrees. Therefore, the sum of interior angles of a pentagon equals to 540 degrees. Sum of angles of the pentagon equals to 540 degrees. Are you clear, students? Yes. Very good. So I think you have any doubts or any queries, you can post to my personal WhatsApp number 9491654321. Thank you, students.